name is Maria Keller and I'm a digital artist from Mexico. On this tutorial, I'll teach you how to create an avatar and added some patterns to create a more unique style. So the first thing we're going to do is open Adobe Illustrator and create a new document. If you don't know how to create one, I'm going to teach you very quickly how. You're going to go to File, New, and select the size that is 800 by 600, and make sure that you pick an RGB color. My interface may be a little bit different because I'm using Illustrator CC, but this same option should be the same on different versions. I'm going to go to my tools panel, and if you click and hold that click, you can see the rest of the shape tools. If you click on this little triangle, you're going to detach the window and you can place it near your canvas. Now I'm going to go and select the rectangle tool or press M and create a rectangle with a width of 110 by 150 pixels. Now I'm going to go to my direct selection tool and go and select the bottom anchor points and then use these little handles to round them all the way to the center, or you could input the value here on the top. Now the next thing I want to create is an ellipse tool, so I'm going to click and create one that is 83 by 83. And you could also click here to constrain both proportions, so I'm going to actually change that to 132 by 132. Click again to create another one. Let's remove the fill, and I'm going to move it around one here and the other one here. I'm going to select both of them and go Window Align to bring these tools right here that I had already opened. Click there on the vertical align center, and then I'm going to click on one, and you can see how the outline has changed, indicating that's a key object. And now just click to distribute the spacing to be zero. I'm going to go to Pathfinder and click on the first option to hit Unite. Now I'm going to select all the shapes, click again on the middle one to make it a key object, and go Horizontal Align Center. Now I'm going to move while pressing Shift the circles a little bit right there. I want to select everything. Again, go to my Pathfinder tools and go minus Front. And I have a shape like this. Now I want to select an ellipse tool and click. And let's make one that is 30 by 30. And let's zoom in a little bit by pressing Ctrl Plus. Let's move it here. Now while I move and drag, I'm going to press Alt and Shift to create a copy. The next thing I want to create is another ellipse. And this one is going to be 14 by 14. I'm going to swap the fill and stroke and move it around here. Again, while clicking and dragging, I'm going to press Alt and Shift to create a copy. I'm going to select both of them and go Object Group. And I'm going to change the color to this purple that I had already selected. You can see the color here. I'm going to change also the color of my stroke to that purple. And I'm going to go to my stroke window, and if you don't see it, remember that you can go Window, Stroke. And I will change the weight to 7. And I'll go here to align your stroke. Make sure that it's aligning to the middle and round the caps and the corners. Now I'm going to select the eyes and the shape. Click again to make the key object and horizontal align center. Now I'm going to go to my pen tool or press P on my keyboard. Make a point there, make another point there, and another point there to create a nose. Now I'm going to create another ellipse. And this one is going to be 28 by 28. I'm going to go to my direct selection tool and remove the top anchor point by pressing delete. Now I'm going to move my mouth, but again, I'm going to align them to the center. Remember to make the key object the object you don't want to move, and move it right here to the bottom. Now I'm going to create another rectangle. And this one is going to be 140 by 230 pixels. Again, make sure that you align them to the center with this align, making sure that you select your key object. Go to your direct selection tool and select the anchor points that are on the top and round them around 60 pixels. That's okay. You can input the value here on the top. Now I'm going to go and create another rectangle. This one is going to be 40 by 60. I'm going to select the bottom anchor points and round them all the way to the center. Again, select both shapes, click on the face to make it the key object, and then go horizontal line center, move it to the bottom a little bit there while pressing shift. Make sure that you do that so you only move on one direction. Now I'm going to create another rectangle, and this one is going to be 180 pixels by 86 pixels. Again, I'm going to go to my direct selection tool, select the top anchor points, and let's now input the value here to 70. Let's select both shapes and make sure that they are aligned. Okay, so now that we have that, we're going to go to our align segment tool, click, and let's make one with an angle of 0. Let's make one that is actually 15 pixels maybe, or actually 20 pixels. Now I'm going to go and find my rotate tool, so click right there and find the rotate tool, or use the shortcut R, and just click on when you rotate, you're going to press Alt and Shift, so you make a copy that is 90 degrees. Now I'm going to go and group this by going to Objects Group and move them around here. Then while I press Alt, I'm going to create a copy. I'm going to go to my ellipse, and this time I'm going to make a small ellipse that is going to be 10 by 10. Sorry, I made a mistake there. So let's change the value here to 10 by 10. And let's move it right there on the bottom and make a copy again by pressing Alt. Now that you have your illustration, all you have to do is go Object Group, then go to your aligned tools, make sure that you're aligning to artboard, and click on horizontal and vertical so you can align them right there to the center. Now you're going to go Window Layers to find this window, and what I want to do is click and drag the layer to create a copy. I'm going to lock that layer that is right there on the top, select this one on the bottom and ungroup. I'm going to delete the parts that are not going to have a fill, and just leave these ones that are going to be containing something. So first thing I want to do is group all the parts that are going to be the face and just unite. Go to my Pathfinder, sorry. And let's remove this area by going to Edit, Copy, and then Edit, Paste in Place, or Ctrl-Shift-P. Now I'm going to do that to delete that face part from the hair. And also I need to delete this part from the hair. So I'm going to do the same again. Ctrl-C, Ctrl-Shift-P to paste in place. And then select both of them. Or actually double click on this one to make it an individual piece. And just go Ctrl-Shift-P to paste that in place and delete that bottom part. I want to remove that part of the face from the t-shirt, so I'm going to do again Ctrl-Shift-P and just delete. Now that you have those, we're ready to create our patterns to fill them. So first thing, I want to create this a line, so I'm just going to click and make one that is, let's leave it in 20, and let's change the, sorry, I'm actually going to make it a little bit width, so I'm going to change the width to 30, and change the color to blue. Let's make the weight 7, select it, go Object, Pattern, Make. And when you do that, you can click there so you change the area that the pattern is being filled. we're going to change the tile type to brick by row, and then press done. Now I'm going to select this bottom part, swap the fill with the stroke, and add that pattern, and you can see how that is right there. Now I'm going to wrench and send it back, and I actually have double piece of this one, so let's zoom out a little bit so we can see that. I'm going to double click on the pattern and let's make the stroke a little bit thicker, so let's change the weight to 5, and again make that bounding box smaller. Now you can see how that changed. Now I want to go and duplicate that pattern by clicking and dragging on the new pattern, and as you can see that you have a copy that's called new pattern 2. I'm going to select the hair and fill it with that new pattern. And what I'm going to do is double click on that one to edit it, and I'm going to change the color to this purple. Click on that one and rotate it with the rotate tool. Again, make sure that you press shift so you rotate it on an angle that is less 90 degrees. And let's change this bounding box to something that is like this. A little bit more on the sides. And I just press done. And you can see how that has already been updated. And now we're gonna go to our ellipse tool and make one that is 8x8. Make sure that you fill it with a pink color. And again, go pattern make. Let's change that bounding box and make it a little bit smaller, sorry, bigger by pressing Alt. You can see how I move it from the center and press done. Now I'm going to select it and fill it. And now all I have to do is remove the stroke, because that's why I had that purple stroke. And now let's turn it on the one that. Now this is looking better, but there are some parts that are intersecting. So we're going to find our scissors tool or press C. And now let's click on the hair. Actually, let's first right click and ungroup it. And now I'm going to press C right there when they are intersecting. And let's just delete, select and delete that part by pressing delete on our keyboard. Let's do the same with the neck. Now I'm going to do the same with this part of the hair. And now if you're having trouble selecting some, all you have to do is double click so you can isolate that shape. And now just, you can feel free to use the scissors tool right there. So let's do that for this shape, removing those parts of the ears. And I'm gonna delete that other one that I had there. And remember that you can keep updating your patterns as much as you need to. So let's actually make something like that. I'm gonna do that part of the t-shirt that I almost forgot. So again, with the scissors, press C on your keyboard and delete that extra part. Now with this, you have finished your avatar that is now filled with patterns. And remember that you can always keep editing as much as you want, and move it around the bounding box or input a value, for example here of 5. So I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.